I'm Carla Hales.
And I'm Luke Wright.
Here at Rave Mag London, we're very excited now the festive season is upon us.
But what's more exciting is the fun-filled episode ahead. Carla, where'd you find chili beans?
Luke, what are you talking about? Oh, I don't know. Where do you find chili beans?
At the North Pole.
Oh yes, laughter is the best medicine, especially at Christmas when you've got indigestion from the turkey and a house full of unhappy families. Or you might want to escape it all and watch one of the latest releases on TV.
Mary Poppins is out now in cinemas.
And has been met with mixed feelings. Fans of the original Mary Poppins movie say there was no need for a remake.
While others say it's setting a positive role model for the next generation of youngsters.
The new film even features Dick Van Dyke. And the real question on everyone's mind is, will his notoriously bad Cockney accent from the original feature again in this movie?
The Hollywood release premiered at the Royal Albert Hall last week in London. And this is what some fans have to say.
In a most delightful I'm really excited for this film. I think the nostalgia from the existing film is going to be riddled throughout. I've heard that the music sort of comes through in the themes. So I'm really excited. I loved the film when I was a kid, Penguins particularly. My expectations are really high. It doesn't sound like we're going to be disappointed. It might have shed a tear or two, maybe. I'm really excited to see Emily Blunt, and I think Lin-Manuel Miranda is going to be incredible. I'm kind of looking forward to the accent more than anything.
I feel like it's a good chance to get a new audience in for the Mary Poppins brand, and it should be a lot of fun and really positive, nice thing for Christmas.
Critics say there's no heart behind the film, complaining it was only produced to churn out more money for Hollywood.
Talking of money, where do snowmen keep their money? In a snowbank!
What? How is that even supposed to be funny?
Even if your jokes don't work this Christmas, maybe you can use the magic of cinema to distract the family from burning down a house. I certainly know what I'm adding to my watch list this Christmas. Our correspondent, Gertrude Ravensbottom, is reporting from 1964, live at the scene where we managed to locate Feed the Birds Lady.
Hello, I'm Gertrude Ravensbottom, reporting live from an undisclosed location in London, where we've managed to track down the original woman from the 1964 film Mary Poppins, the Feed the Birds Lady. This is Jane Darwell. Good afternoon. Lovely to meet you. I'm a great fan.
Feed the birds!
Pretty sure your career skyrocketed after you filmed that film.
Feed the birds!
Would you say that your career was over-sensationalised? Was it an accurate representation?
Feed the birds!
Right. Would you say you had much creative input in the role? I know it must be very exhausting.
Feed the birds! Feed the birds!
We'll just leave that there. Back
feed
to studio. The
birds.
Back to
feed
studio.
The birds. Feed the birds!
Well, thank you for that, Gertrude. I don't quite know what to
say.
I don't know about you, Luke, but I don't agree with the casting choice of Emily Blunt as Mary Poppins.
Why? Who do you think should act as Mary Poppins?
Certain young TV personality. She hasn't done much acting so much, but mainly TV presenting.
I think Emily Blunt was the perfect choice. But as you can see, Mary Poppins Returns has certainly divided the nation.
Reminds me of something else that divided the nation as of June 2016.
Something to look forward to in Rant or Rave.
But don't hold your breath. First, the ad break.
But before the ad break, the weather.
Oh, yes. First, the weather. Second, the ad break. The weather forecast for this winter season is sunshine, chances of sunshine, and if you're lucky, some extra sunshine. Temperatures roughly around 25 degrees, so get ready to build those sandcastles and work on your tan.
And now for the short films.
I got That's that yay blood. That's that
fucking shit. You're better than this, you know. You're absolutely better than this. To see why you crazy. Think of all life, you're absolutely ridiculous. I'm sorry, I want you to take it off. I want you to shut up and listen to me, darling. Because I am trying to convince you to convince yourself. You are better than these people. Better than these. Just a drug dealer. Just a drug dealer. Got one song, they say drug dealer. Nothing to say but drug dealer. You're mediocre, I can't pee. Hey, you don't have any self-respect or any decency. No, you're better than these people. You would tell them it's not popping. So when you're blue, they say you truly look fantastic, darling. Fantastic. Yeah, you're living your dream on these as well.
Drug dealer, what else can I do? Businessman, I don't. Businessman, minding my business, got a business plan. Your foundation's been built on sand. Sinking sand, now you're sinking, man. Your chick, she was linking, man. Before she linked you, she had things in hand. Call her your princess, man. But her only interest is linking, man.
Slept with her mom.
I didn't mean to. I was in the pizza down the pub.
What do you mean you didn't mean to? How is that possible?
It's a mistake.
She bumped into her. Hello and welcome back to Rave Mag London.
Very soon on air, we have two very special guests.
Gary, the self-professed Brexiteer from Stoke-on-Trent.
And Priscilla, the psychic, known for her sixth sense.
Time for Rant or Rave. First off, let's welcome Gary. You have 1 minute to present your case.
Britain leaving Europe is well good. We never really needed them other countries in the first place, innit? We're called Great Britain because we're great. This way, we keep our money, keep our jobs, and keep our border. So what if the sterling drops in value for a bit? So what if we have another recession? It'll all be worth it in the end. I myself work in the construction industry and I can guarantee you that after Brexit there will be plenty of jobs for me and my lads to crack on with. I bet on my life it does. You see, I've got a growth mindset I do. I read that book I did. Mind as soon as you, with this dilly-dallying, with these negotiations is over, you'll thank the people with common sense who saved our great nation by voting you. So if any of you's lot behind the telly got a decent head on your shoulders, vote Leave. And you can't say no to that lovely woman, Theresa May. She is just such a powerful, beautiful broad, oh my days.
We've heard what Gary has to say. Now over to Priscilla to present her case on Brexit.
With my sixth sense, I gaze into the future of post-Brexit Britain. London now is a beautiful place, but London in the future? Let me think. No, I see disaster. It will be a lawless land with no food or healthcare. People with skill will have long fled. A few countries will trade with us. Every time I gaze into my crystal ball, I see an oppressed nation and murderous unemployment. Students and the young will suffer. The youth of Britain never asked for this horrendousness. What else? I see rampant racism, sexism and homophobia. The land will be ruled by the cruel, cold-hearted and ignorant. Ethnic minorities will suffer. Oh no, I see a kingdom ununited. We will become the ununited kingdom. I ask you to vote for me. I feel it in my bones that Brexit is a dreadful thing.
Thanks, you two. Now for the big question.
Do you vote Gary for Brexit or Priscilla for the European Union?
Get voting, guys.
And the results are in.
Looks like it's 50-50.
What's wrong with you people? What's this nation coming to? It's an outrage! An outrage!
Sorry folks, it looks like that's all we have time for this evening.
Have a Merry Christmas, a Happy New Year.
And a miserable Brexit.
I don't want a lot for Christmas. There is just one thing I need. And I don't care about the bigots who undermine democracy. I just want freedom of movement. Live and work in any place. Theresa May will make me happy. We'll employ next month of March. I just want a free trade zone. More than you could ever know. Make my wish come true. Maybe all I want for Christmas is you. You, baby. I won't ask for much this Christmas. I won't even wish for snow. I'm just gonna keep on waiting underneath the window. I will make a list and send it, cause it's all an evil trick. I won't even say you're waiting. Watch the sterling fall and sing. I just want you tonight, holding on to all my rights. Well, now can I do? Really all I want for Christmas is you.
I'm Gala Hales.
And I'm Luke Wright.
Here at Rave Mag London, we're very excited now the festive season is upon us.
But what's more exciting is the fun-filled episode ahead. Gala, where'd you find chili beans?
Luke, what are you talking about? Oh, I don't know, where do you find chili beans?
At the North Pole.
Oh yes, laughter is the best medicine. Especially at Christmas when you've got indigestion from the turkey in a house full of unhappy families. Or you might want to escape it and watch one of the latest releases on TV.
Mary Poppins is out now in cinemas.
And has been met with mixed feelings. Fans of the original Mary Poppins movie say there was no need for a remake.
While others say it's setting a positive female role model for the next generation of youngsters.
The new film even features Dick Van Dyke, and the real question on everyone's mind is, will his notoriously bad Cockney accent from the original feature again in this movie?
The Hollywood release premiered at the Royal Albert Hall in London last week, and this is what some fans have to say.
In a most delightful I'm really excited for this film. I think the nostalgia from the existing film is going to be riddled throughout. I've heard that the music sort of comes through in the themes, so I'm really excited. I loved the film when I was a kid. penguins particularly. My expectations are really high. It doesn't sound like we're going to be disappointed. It might have shed a tear or two, maybe. I'm really excited to see Emily Blunt, and I think Lin-Manuel Miranda is going to be incredible. I'm kind of looking forward to the accent more than anything.
I feel like it's a good chance to get a new audience in for the Mary Poppins brand, and it should be a lot of fun and really positive, nice thing for Christmas.
Critics say there's no heart behind the film, complaining it was only produced to churn out more money for Hollywood.
Talking of money, where do snowmen keep their money? In a snowbank.
What? How is that even supposed to be funny?
Even if jokes don't work this Christmas, maybe you can use the magic of cinema to distract that family from burning down the house. I certainly know what I'm adding to my watch list for this holiday. Our special correspondent, Gertrude Ravensbottom, reporting from 1964, is live at the scene where we have managed to locate the Feed the Birds lady.
Hello, I'm Gertrude Ravensbottom, reporting live from an undisclosed location in London, where we've managed to track down the original woman from the 1964 film Mary Poppins, the Feed the Birds lady. This is Jane Darwell. Good afternoon. Lovely to meet you. I'm a great fan.
Feed the birds!
Pretty sure your career skyrocketed after you filmed that film.
Feed the birds!
Would you say that your career was over-sensationalised? Was it an accurate representation?
Feed the birds!
Right, would you say you had much creative input in the role? I know it must be very exhausting.
Feed the birds! Feed the birds!
We'll just leave that there. Back
feed
to studio. The birds. Back to
feed
studio.
The birds. Feed the
Well, thank you for that, Gertrude. I don't quite know what to
say.
I don't know about you, Luke, but I don't agree with the casting choice of Emily Blunt for Mary Poppins.
Why? Who do you think should act as Mary Poppins?
Certain young TV personality. She hasn't done much acting herself. Mainly TV presenting?
I think Emily Blunt was a perfect choice for the role. But as you can see, Mary Poppins Returns has clearly divided the nation.
Reminds me of something else that divided the nation as of June 2016.
Something to look forward to later in Rant or Rave.
Don't hold your breath. First, the ad break.
But before the break, the weather.
Oh, yes. First, the weather. Second, the ad break. The weather forecast for this winter season is sunshine, with a chance of sunshine and, if you're lucky, a little bit more sunshine. Temperatures are roughly 25 degrees, so get ready to build those sandcastles and work on your tan.
And now for the short films.
Been built on sand, sinking sand, now you're sinking, man. Your chick, she was linking, man. Before she linked you, she had things in hand. Call her your princess, man, but her only interest is linking, man.
Oh,
can't believe you slept with her mom.
I didn't mean to.
What do you mean you didn't mean to?
Bumped into her.
Oh. Hello and welcome back, Rave Mag London.
Tonight on air, we have two very special guests.
Gary, the self-professed Brexiteer from Stoke-on-Trent.
And Priscilla, the psychic, known for her sixth sense and seeing into the future.
It's time for
Rant or Rave.
First off, let's welcome Gary. You now have 1 minute to tell us what you think about Brexit.
Britain leaving Europe is well good. We never really need them other countries in the first place, innit? We're called Great Britain because we're grapes. This way, we keep our money, keep our jobs, keep our border. So what if the sterling drops in value for a bit? So what if we have another recession? It'll all be worth it in the end. I, myself, work in the construction industry. And I can guarantee you that, yeah, after Brexit, there'll be plenty of work for me and my lads to crack on with. I bet on my life I does. You see, I've got a growth mindset, I do. I read that book I did. Mind you, as soon as this dilly-dallying with these negotiations is over, you'll thank the people with the common sense who saved our great nation by voting leave. So if any of you lots behind the telly got a decent head on your shoulders, vote leave. I love you, Theresa May. I hope you're hearing this. I love you.
We've heard what Gary has to say. Now over to Priscilla to present her case on Brexit. Priscilla, you have 1 minute.
With my sixth sense, I gaze into the future of post-Brexit Britain. London now is a beautiful place, but London in the future? Let me think. No. I see disaster. It will be a lawless land with no food or healthcare. People with skill will have long fled. Few countries will trade with us. Every time I gaze into my crystal ball, I see an oppressed nation and murderous unemployment. Students and the young will suffer. The youth of Britain never asked for this horrendousness. What else? I see rampant racism, sexism and homophobia. The land will be ruled by the cruel, cold-hearted and ignorant. Ethnic minorities will suffer. Oh no, I see a kingdom ununited. We will become the ununited kingdom. I ask you to vote for me. I feel it in my bones that Brexit is a dreadful thing.
Thank you, you two. Now for the big question.
Do you vote for Gary and Brexit or for Priscilla and the European Union?
Get voting, guys.
And the results are in.
Looks like it's 50-50.
Oh, come off here. What's wrong with you people? What's this nation coming to? It's an outrage. An outrage.
Sorry, folks. That's all we have time for tonight.
Have a Merry Christmas, a Happy New Year.
And the miserable Brexit.
I don't want a lot for Christmas. There is just one thing I need. I don't care about the figures, undermine democracy. I just want freedom of movement, live and work in any place. Theresa May will make me happy with a ploy next month of March. I just want a free trade zone, more than you could ever know. Make my wish come true. Maybe all I want for Christmas is you, baby. Won't ask for much this Christmas. I won't even wish for snow. I'm just gonna keep on waiting underneath the Christmas snow. I will make a list and send it, cause it's all an evil trick. I won't even stay awake, watch the sterling fall and sink. I just want you tonight, holding on to me so tight. What more can I do? Maybe all I want for Christmas. Christmas is you.